Yeah.
What do we do? Oh.
Not sure what we're doing.
Hi, I'm Tina.
I'm Christine Barrington, the Adult Community-Based Services Director.
Very nice to meet you.
You too.
Hi, I'm Eric Cedars.
Eric, hi.
Nice to meet you in person.
Like,
I've talked to you.
We've talked on the phone so much. I didn't remember. I was like, I feel like we've met one another.
We haven't met, but we've visited a few times. Nice day for a drive,
it's
huh?
It's beautiful. Yeah. It's just a beautiful. Yeah, hi.
Hi, I'm Teresa O'Donnell-Ebner. I'm new to the board here, but I live in La Crescent, so I'll visit with you a little bit later, too.
Oh, that's very much. Nice to meet you. Yeah. Hi.
Tim Hunter, Director of Development for all 3 weeks.
Yes.
How's it going?
Not bad.
Good. How do you do?
Hi, I'm Scott Sherman, Mayor of Winona.
Oh, hi, Mayor. So nice to, I don't know if we've met before.
No, we have not.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much. Hello. I'm Rachel Martin. I'm a board member for many years. Oh, thank you,
awesome.
Betsy, for your board service. That's wonderful.
Having you here.
Yeah,
in your place.
This is Lexi, and you may probably have met
Lexi,
right?
Hi.
We might have one more board member join us, Matt Baird, in the middle of the tour. So
sure, that sounds great.
We just start the.
This is Amy, who works with me.
So we're going to show you just the main floor. One of the things we did actually in response to the pandemic is we moved. We used to have services throughout the entire building for the public, but we moved everything to the first floor.
Uh-huh.
So unless you, second floor is all staff.
Okay.
So it makes it easier for the public. We don't have people having to track through the entire building. But the front part is a drop-in center for adults and a medication clinic. So Christy, do you want to lead the way?
Great. Thank you. Come on in. So do you want to see this space?
That's okay.
Okay. So this is our current bedroom.
Varies between daily. Some people come in daily, some people come in weekly, some people come in bi-weekly.
Uh-huh.
Fill a med box, and then that way the staff here actually help track, make sure meds are refilled. Yep. We have the new pharmacy, so that was awesome.
That's really great.
She was just carrying a basket full of meds, so that's kind of what she goes and gets the meds, brings them over here. That way we don't have to run out, we don't have to worry about those kinds of things, and so individuals remember what the meds are.
Yeah.
We teach them what their meds are, we teach them what their symptoms are, the side effects are, and then coordinate with them to talk to their providers.
So we teach the skills, and we also help support people on like commitments or probation, just help them be more successful and get back out in the community with less restrictions.
So are people who are coming in here, tell me what kinds of illnesses they're dealing with.
It
really run the gamut?
It really does. It can be any, you know, an SBMI, so schizophrenia, bipolar, borderline personality, PTSD, and then as well as a lot of substance abuse disorders as well.
Mm-hmm.
Or even generalized anxiety, autism. We pretty much serve anyone that qualifies for our service. People are voluntary as well. Some clients just really enjoy the support because it's really hard to keep track of all those medications.
Sure, right.
And remember to take them. And the reordering process can be very daunting.
So they'll come in here, those folks will come in here, and it gives them a way of just sort of grounding, figuring out what's going on.
Yep, they bring the med box in, they open it up, and they put their meds in, and we talk about when they take them, and you know, if there's any barriers to taking them. You know, one client falls asleep in her chair often at night, so we talk about like what ways can we maybe prevent that from happening a little bit earlier, keep it by your chair, just so we can promote taking them as prescribed.
Do you think that most people who come in here have housing?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think almost everybody in here has some sort of housing, whether that's with family. We have some people in supportive living environments. We also serve people in group home settings, independently. We have some homeless that will come in here. It just kind of depends. So everybody's situation is a little bit different.
Right. Right. And how do people get connected into Hiawatha Healthcare? Like, how do they end up finding their way through the door?
a lot of ways.
Yes.
There's a lot of ways, yeah.
So to get into here, a prescriber typically.
I want everyone to know I'm getting over a cold. I tested negative for COVID yesterday, so.
So to get into the medication clinic, yeah, a prescriber has to make that recommendation, or a therapist or case manager makes that recommendation that maybe the person is just having a harder time knowing what meds they're taking. Meds change frequently with mental health meds, and so trying to make sure that we have them all up to date as best as we can. So if they just need a little extra support, they make a referral to us.
Let's show the drop-in center. So it's we call it a drop-in. It's a peer support network.
Yeah.
Started this a number of years ago, and actually, it's in this portion.
So because of COVID, we ended up moving our medication clinic to a bigger space so that we could be more conscientious of the Medicare, the symptoms of COVID, and trying to make sure that people were able to still come in and get meds,
right,
and not be at risk.
Yeah,
so
sure.
We moved all that over there and then just kind of condensed PSN space. PSN was closed for about a year, but we've opened up in June of last year and have been open ever since.
Our hope too is to open up fully in the months ahead. We plan to make our old men room bigger and more suitable for a future health crisis emergency. So, you know, I've sat in you'll see they have lunch bunches, and this is just, I've sat in some of the groups, and the stories of people, it's just a place where people belong. It's nothing we get paid for. The county went on and helps us some with some of the costs, but it's just it's a drop-in center.
Right.
People come in and just hang out.
Right.
Safe, sober.
Yeah.
We had quite a large group in here earlier. So it just varies on the time. And
so do you do the programming, or do they just, do groups sort of form organically, or?
No, we have like the book club, the breakfast club, the lunch bunch.
Yeah.
Nutrition class. So we have various clubs that they can come into and join a group.
Yeah.
You can just be from the community, but you don't have to be, you don't have a discipline.
We have a really good relationship with local universities too that have kids do placements within this setting. So we have a part-time coordinator and staff. A peer specialist is in here quite a bit. And then students through Winona State, St. Mary's maybe.
Mostly WSU, we had 6 students last semester that did their internship.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's really great.
Yeah.
Right.
So this is a service that you provide that's very difficult, if not impossible, to get reimbursed for. But you know how important it is to people.
Well, the fact that with it being any adult in the community can just come in here. So because of that, we don't have any prior authorization. So it's just it's like we have rec centers in Winona, where you go, you're over there, you guys have the same, you guys look a lot like that, you do. For kids just to show up and hang out and be with each other, and that's what this space is for adults in Winona too.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll go back up to the main hall.
Good.
Thank you.
Everyone's so shy.
I know, I'm full of like, I don't want to be in the way.
I don't want to be in the front.
Did you come through Lake City?
Yeah, we did. We came down through Lake City.
That's
right. Oh, you did? I love Lake City. We stopped in Red Wing this morning.
We have a clinic. We have a clinic at Red Wing. We actually have 2 locations now as well. So General Pharmacy joined our agency about.
Oh, that's great.
Maybe 9 months.
Hi, I'm Tina.
Sorry, I didn't give you a heads up that she'd be coming around today, but we did the grand opening maybe a month ago.
That's great.
Yeah.
So you both are pharmacists?
I'm a technician, and then the pharmacist.
Yeah.
So just the 2 of us here. Yeah.
So to have an onsite, I mean, you know all of us, statistics on the value. Have an onsite for the patients.
And it's mostly because when people kind of cover a lot of them beyond over a regular pharmacy.
When pre-COVID, we used all of this.
We are proactive. We're our patients on site. We have stopping medication pills. We have special packaging that helps them to be able to take it, especially because something's wrong with their medication.
Yeah.
Helps with compliance a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
We offer mailing and we deliver to the residentials and pull up here.
Oh, you can even, that's so great. That's, and you've only been open for about 2 months, is that right?
And for our agency, the nice thing is I think it took about 5 feet of storage for us to have a pharmacy. It didn't cause, I mean, how many, you're in hundreds of clinics like ours in the country, right?
Yeah, there's like 600.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's so interesting. Is it a for-profit pharmacy or non?
It is a for-profit.
Well, it's a closed pharmacy.
I mean, I'm just curious about the business model. That's terrific.
Yeah, usually only like the hospital.
Yeah. Right.
And what was your name again?
I'm Tina Smith. I'm the United States Senator from Minnesota.
I know.
So, yeah, nice to meet you too.
I vote for you.
No, I really do. And my name is Amy Smith.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
But anyway, I heard it on the radio that you're really.
Here I am, yep.
It was nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you both. Yeah, thank you.
So we're part of 30 or so throughout the state, the Minnesota Association of Human Health Programs.
Yeah.
A lot of them have Genoa, Zumbro Valley and Rochester.
That's great.
South Central Middle, so they've been a great, great addition.
Yeah.
We'll head this way.
All right.
Is Matt here?
So how long have you been on the board?
How long have you been? 8 years?
Before I got here. Yeah, I think 8 years.
I'm glad to hear.
I'm a registered nurse and I'm the manager of behavioral health services at the hospital.
Oh, sorry.
Hi, Robin.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
So I just walked by these two reception areas, so this side, today we have all our outpatient clinic-based therapists over there, so mental therapy, psychological testing, and tele. And then on this side, we've added care coordinators with our CCBHC certification. We're hoping to have 7 this year, and I think we're close to that. And so they're over on this side, our psychiatry department, and then our intake staff, and then reception. Well, I don't know how many clients.
Yeah, I don't want to disturb people.
So it's just a clinical space.
Yeah, right.
So that's, this is our largest location here in Winona. Three other clinics like this. So this is I have kind of a bad diet. This is what we're going to do thanks to all you. This actually used to be Winona. What do you have here? So this is our makeshift.
Yeah, that's good.
At the funding through Congress, we helped create 2 nice treatment room group rooms in here, and then three smaller spaces for care coordinators and individual therapy for tele services. So we can talk more about it if you want to waste it down, but the funding for construction and filling the space with things to do the work, that's all going to happen in this space.
That's so great.
It's wonderful.
Yeah.
I know throughout the process, I'm like, you're joking. Like, what are you talking about? This doesn't happen at places like ours. But it
should.
It will be wonderful.
Yeah.
And so, So any questions? Right. Otherwise, that's the extent of the tour.
Okay, should we have a seat? Should we sit down?
We'll go back.
Thank you that's really great.
Thank you.
So this space will basically be divided up into smaller rooms and we're used. Okay, we can look at it. That's right. I'll come back.
Yes, good idea.
This is